Hello, Pisces. How are you today? Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna. So we're going to get started here with your reading. We have regeneration. What are you reinventing, regenerating, bringing back to life? That's a transformation card, Pisces. Yang energy, bringing a lot of power, a lot of action into the situation to make things better in your love life. We have TikTok. What is ticking and talking for you? So this is a two-part reading. I'm going to do the traditional love spread. I'm going to do the clarifiers as usual. And then I'm going to tell you the 9 to 10 things about you that your love interest likes best. Okay. So let's see here what we have for our beautiful Pisces friends. I just saw the Knight of Cups pass by, and that is your energy. So you're here. All right, so let's see what we have for the bottom of the deck. We have the energy of, Eight of Cups. You've walked away from something, Pisces. Ooh, into something new and special and happy. Okay, so let's go ahead and start this reading. We have for the energy that is mutual between you and your love interest, the recent past, the King of Pentacles. Ooh, Daddy, do we love you? We love the energy of being nurtured by one another. That's what I see. It is known as the Daddy card because it's somebody who is very successful, very loyal, very passionate, and very much Taurus energy, all about the family, making things work, and really building a legacy. The mutual current energy is the Temperance card. For some of you, this may be a reconciliation, but at any rate, Temperance card is coming together, being very balanced. Archangel Raphael is the angel that is protecting the relationship, but Temperance is Sagittarius energy. It is energy that believes in doing the right thing. We have the Ace of Cups. How does your person feel about you in their heart space? How do they see the relationship developing? They see themselves falling in love with you, and certainly they're wondering if you have fallen in love with them, Pisces, the Two of Coins. They do view you as a person who might be juggling, who has not really made a decision about this relationship fully, that you're keeping possibly, an option open, not dating necessarily exclusively. How do they feel in their heart space? Cancerian energy. They're falling in love. It's deep. That's a very nurturing energy. That's someone who's feeling a bit overwhelmed with their emotions currently. How do they view the two of you moving forward? Ouch. Three of Swords. Okay. So now we're in this energy that we see whenever I get the Two of Coins and the Three of Swords. Your person, Pisces, thinks that you may have another. You may actually, this is a third party situation. It may be well known to both of you. There may be a requirement for, you or the other person to walk away. What's hidden in the energy is the Judgment card. That is the energy between the two of you. Spirit is recommending that the two of you have a victory together. What is the outcome at this time? The Strength card, fire in your belly. The two of you are very loyal to one another. The two of you love each other deeply. But let's look and see what's going on here, because your person, Pisces, feels as though they may face heartbreak with you. Why is the Eight of Cups here? Tell us something about what was left behind or why this is a theme, healing. The Nine of Pentacles. And the Ace of Swords. Okay. So what the energy that I'm getting here is that in the recent past, one or both of you have walked away from another situation. Both of you have gone through a healing process. You're both single now, ready to mingle, according to the overall energy. The Ace of Swords, though, is truth and clarity. So one person has definitely walked away and become single after a period of being married, it looks like, or attached or committed. Why do we have the Knight of Pentacles, or the King of Pentacles here? Why is the King of Pentacles here? Six of Swords, moving forward. Healing. This is a card of healing. It's the card of having, of moving forward. So, does, again, it looks like one of you has left a relationship or a third party situation. Does look, though, Pisces, as though your person feels it's you. Okay, so we have the Temperance card, Reconciliation card, as clarified by the Hermit card. So it looks like for some of you, you're actually in separation right now from your person. For others of you, you've already been through the separation and you're back with them with that reconciliation. The Eight of Coins, your person sees a way forward, is doing the work, being diligent, getting to know what you need, getting to know how to address those needs. We also see they see you as somebody with the Ace of Wands energy. You want a new beginning with them. The Eight of Swords, though, says that you haven't taken any action. So we see that energy. Why are they? This Queen of Cups energy is really a beautiful love. We have the Princess of Pentacles. So your person is making an offer. They're madly in love with you. They are very much feeling as though they want to be married to you. I'm going to say straight up, for some of you, this is going to be a multi-layered reading. Because for some of you, this is a third-party situation. You've left a marriage, you've been single, and now you're coming to them. For others of you, it's going to be almost the reverse. It's going to be that you've left this person behind, and now you've come back in to reconcile with them, and you're still not necessarily sure, Pisces, about the future of the relationship. Your person, though, is. Your person is very clear-cut in what they want with you. So it's going to be you making this decision. Why is the Three of Swords here? What does it represent in this Pisces reading? Three of, okay, good. Excellent, excellent. So basically, your person sees you as having made a choice because the Three of Swords is third party, but now your person sees the way forward as very clear cut. You've both chosen each other. The energy is a judgment, probably judgment of divorce, quite literally. It does look like the two of you may have met when one of you was married, were married. So we have the energy here, Pisces, of the Scorpio judgment card, Two of Swords. Not paying attention to the fact that you're both free. High Priestess. So right now, the two of you are not discussing the relationship much. It looks like you're both just being very quiet. You're both just hoping for the best. You're both giving yourself time to work through the details of coming together fully. So let's see. We have Six of Cups, Reconciliation. So there we go. You know, I really like this energy for you, Pisces, because it really speaks to the fact that you, you know, a third party situation appears to have turned into a relationship in which you can count on. But your outcome card is clarified. Although you have a very strong relationship, both of you are ending this period of time. It's a timeless reading. But you're not making, you're very dedicated to each other. The strength of the relationship is going forward, but you're not making any decisions right now. Basically, it's just, you know, you're taking your time. Spirit says you're going to have to make a decision pretty soon. But right now, as you, as this reading is concluding, it shows, you know, just basically staying open. You are holding on to each other, but you're not making any conclusive decisions about timing is what I'm seeing. So let's look and see what your person adores about you best, Pisces. What does your person love about you best? What does Pisces person love about them best? Six of Swords, beautiful energy. They feel as though you're able to get over things, that you're able in any relationship to leave the past behind, to regenerate the relationship. They feel as though you definitely like to move forward in a very strong way and that you don't like to linger in pain. Tick tock. You always put a time limit on things that are painful. So
Seven of Wands says that they really feel that you know how to stand your ground, that when other people get your attention and you don't want it, that you ward them off. So they're very happy about that. The Moon card, they see you as very mysterious, very haunting, a little bit scary because they don't know, but that is Pisces energy. They see you as very mysterious, very exhilarating. They like it. They like that about you, that you don't just spill the beans. The World card, they think the world of you, quite literally. They put you on a pedestal. They see you as being, you know, everything that they could possibly want in this lifetime in love. The Magician card, they see you as magical. The chemistry is so great between the two of you. Again, it really speaks to the mystery of love and the relationship they have with you, Pisces. You always have a trick up your sleeve emotionally, but it's a very joyful card also, the way I'm feeling this. It's a joyful energy. The Five of Wands says that you will have a healthy debate with them, Pisces. Your person can't get one over on you. You like to spar with each other. It kind of revs both of you up and makes you feel excited and enthusiastic. You also like to discuss current affairs. How is the world going? The Justice card says that the two of you are very good at banter. We see the Eight of Cups. Oh, between the two of you, yes, now we have it. That basically, what's hidden in this relationship is that, you know, one of you had to walk away to come into the relationship, to become single. It looks like one of you really, you know, that's what's hidden here. You're not talking about it, though. You're not talking about the past. You're really very much in the energy of the future. So they love the fact that you walked away when you didn't feel in love. When you fell in love with them, that you walked away from a situation that was critical for the two of you to be together. The Page of Wands, you threw caution to the winds. They have so much respect for you, Pisces, that you did that, that you chose them. You had the courage to do it. Nine of Pentacles, once again, Pisces. They see you as amazingly single after having been in a third-party situation with you. So, Pisces, that's your reading. I hope you like this part. Please tell me below if you like this section of the reading. Sending you love from Chicago. Send some back and tell me where you're from. Thanks so much, Pisces. Hope to see you again in another video. Thank you.